being born into a Illuminati bloodline or being born into a family that has been involved in generational, multi-generational, ongoing depravity and wickedness is nothing like what people think about when they hear the phrase, pop culturally, an Illuminati person. Just being born into the Reynolds bloodline, the Reynolds were not necessarily the preeminent purebloods. However, other individuals of my lineage carry darker seeds in their blood, if you will. They genuinely believe that they are carriers of the seed of the serpent. These people are builders of worlds, as they believe it. And the worlds they build are absolutely set in the cornerstones of darkness. And the reality is it's a far more sophisticated system that has been architected and built into the fabric of our society. If you show certain aptitudes at early ages, they will darken you through traumatic systemic abuse. The chosen ones would be the child that's been selected as having the best predisposition to being able to endure intense amounts of trauma, fracture their mind through what's called dissociation. This is later on what can develop into dissociative identity disorder, what used to be called multiple personality disorder. And that really is the black heart of this kingdom. And that's the big secret. They're always telling people to hush, hush. And the reality is they're hiding this big bad boogeyman, which is split personality, mind control, and handlers and individuals that use people like cattle. I had a higher level of intelligence. And so when they split me, I had the ability to maintain aspects of my core at a high level and still have one personality that could function for the cult and be cult loyal, my Nightwalker side. And then I had another front side that was a Christian moral side that was a Daywalker. So this, the left hand doesn't know what the right hand is doing, is what this is all about, divide and conquer tactics. And they base these things off the principles of the Word of God, which says a house divided against itself cannot stand. And that's exactly what they do, is they split someone so they can never stand against the enemy ever again. And the goal is always to shatter the mind so you can control that individual. And my grandfather and other members of his brotherhood were Jesuits. There's no way around it. And the Jesuits make some of the best mind control splitters in the world, including and up to assassins, which is what I ended up showing an aptitude for. By appearing to be a good Christian and knowing the language and being in the private Christian schools and being around and saturating yourself in a Christian environment all the time, it gives you the ability to blend into that environment at will. You can become that. And that's what my aptitudes were, is that I became this chameleon. Wherever environment was, I took on the emotional form of whatever my targets or people around me needed me to be so that I could fulfill my purpose there, whether I was being sent in to infiltrate a group or whether I was just being sent in to plant cameras so that we could capture blackmail evidence of sexual abuse and incest or pedophilia, which was my most common trait when I was younger, when I was working with a lot of the individuals out of the Knights of Columbus and the Jesuits. They really like to control people through setting them up with compromising videos. Compromise is their kingdom. And so they're very, very good at making sure to find ways to have a little black book on you and your dirty deeds. And my family got very wealthy by selling secrets, by selling these little black books of individuals who later may have become prominent or may not. And either way, they compromise them young, they compromise them early, they find people that have certain aptitudes towards, say, diplomacy. When you realize that everybody at certain areas of our political system, military-industrial complex, operates under these confines and constraints, you'll understand why there's not real change. There's no real impactful difference done if you work in their system. And that's why it is so critical for people to learn that God had dictated a different system that he outlined in his word for how we're supposed to walk out of Babylon and into peace and into deliverance and into hope and joy and rest. And my book and this story is not something that was watched and experienced. This was something my wife and my daughter and I have lived and breathed and fought for tooth and nail to survive. Because coming out of this will cost you everything. And I'm not gonna sit here and sugarcoat over that. If you are in this, if you are someone who has been involved in this, if this has touched your life, You need to understand that there is deliverance available to you no matter how dark it's been. And my darkness is darker than the abyss. I have tasted the black waters of the tombs of death. And those who are in there know exactly of what I speak. And when you've drunk of the serpent seed, you know that you are defiled on a scale that most people don't know is real. But I know this, that there is nothing the enemy has done to me that the Lord Jesus Christ has not undone and set me free from and given me a new purpose and a new calling so that I can turn around and take those same gifts and talents and mindsets and abilities and wash them into a new mind and be transformed. This book, what it is a very real, awesome look into what it's like for someone like my wife, who may not have been born into this or known what it was she was getting into when she met me, but she stayed with me through this. And this book is so much really our love story and what a real marriage looks like. It's not pretty, but it's powerful. And that's what I want to make sure people know, that it's better to have a purposeful life than it is to have an empty one.